Simply Done, the podcast network.
Watch. Get the fucking mic, you fucking moron.
Go ahead and sit in your seat. Headphones.
No mold today. I don't know where the fuck mold is. But we gotta get this thing going. That's why I waited so long.
Okay.
How clumsy are you?
Well,
I'm sorry for bumping into that mic ears.
All right. Well, no more. We got to get this thing fucking going. Okay? We're going to have to carry
What's going on with the douchebag?
I don't know. Coming to you pre-recorded from Simply Down, the podcast network studios at a secret location in West Hollywood, California, it's the Big Three Podcast. Hey, I'm your old pal, Don Barris.
And I'm, of course, Scary Perry.
Right now, we don't have Mole.
You're the guy.
Yeah, I don't know if he's late. I don't know what the hell's going on. But we've got no Mole.
Got an absentee.
So what's been going on with you just to start things?
Been kind of tied up and tied down.
What do you mean tied up and tied down?
I'm just kind of busy with personal matters.
Well, what are your personal matters?
I can't talk about them.
What do you mean you can't talk about them? You sit here, we've got nothing to talk about.
Do have things to talk about.
We don't have anything to talk about.
Well, why don't you bring up... Well, okay, then I'm going to bring it up. What's going on in the Middle East? They gave that guy 25 years, which means life.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about the guy that fucking murdered all those Israelis.
When did you all of a sudden become a newsworthy guy?
Because I watched the news constantly.
All right, makes sense to me. Tell me what's going on then.
Okay. For all those years that the Israelis in Cairo were being shot and killed and stuff, I forget this guy's name.
Wait a minute. So you're doing a report on a guy whose name you don't even know.
I can't because...
So let's not talk about that.
Okay, next subject.
All right, let's talk about what your personal stuff is.
Certain personal things I'm unable to bring up.
Why?
Legal matters I cannot talk about.
Everybody, even in a listening audience, knows that you're suing your family.
But I can't... There's certain... I can't talk about it anymore.
Why?
I can't... Because legally it's not to be mentioned.
Why?
Because!
Why? Why?
Period.
Then let's just sit here.
And stare at each other. My gorgeous hazel blue-brown eyes. And your blue eyes.
You think your eyes are better looking than mine?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Tell me what's going on with your family. Just tell me a little. Give the listeners something to at least dig their teeth into.
Okay, my brother Brian's hair is getting grayer and grayer.
You know what that means?
Yeah.
What?
He's losing.
Well, no. The nerves are getting to him.
Exactly.
Right, but that's not really telling us what's going on.
Well, I can't answer that matter because I'm not allowed to.
All right, well, then let's do this, and maybe we'll talk about that in a little while. It's time once again for our Cookie Caramello update. Mole's not here, so I'll say, drum roll! Now, Sonny Cookie Caramello, that's your father. That's your father. Now, Cookie was a cook in the Navy, and he served tours of duty in World War II and in the Korean conflict. Where Cookie is most famous is because what he did, he was a leader. He was a leader in the fight the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy came
into being. Can I cut in? He was most famous for building all the buildings that he built in Chicago.
Okay, that's not what we're concerned about. Okay. I think the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy, that he was putting himself out there before that went into effect. But then, February 6th came along. The doctors felt, this is it. There's no hope for Cookie. We've got to pull the plugs. He was in the hospital. They pulled the plugs. And every week we ask, Is Cookie still with us?
Yes.
Jeez, the guy's indestructible.
So far, so good. He's getting healthier.
Does he have any life at all?
Yeah.
Like, what do you mean?
I mean, I can talk to him and stuff. He watches TV. He walks, but he's got to use the walker.
Yeah, so is he able to get out and do anything?
He can't drive anymore.
Okay. Well, I want to get into this because on June 25th, as a lot of you know, is our big holiday show. That's where we celebrate Perry getting into show business by jerking someone off and letting them blow him. But now, the thing that I still, to this day, and this is what pisses me off, Perry, and I can kind of understand why you get upset. Because, you know, I'll get people that say, oh, Perry blew him. That's not what happened.
No. You both don't understand. You, as well as all the audience members, don't understand.
Well, explain yourself.
I got in trouble. It was my first film shoot. I felt like
You didn't know.
I felt like a stud. I kind of got in trouble.
All right, well, anyway, we're not talking about that. This is why we're having the show. Now, it's on June 25th, and at midnight, we celebrate this holiday by popping champagne, because at midnight, the 26th is the actual date that you had your little rendezvous with the Randy Callahan. So what we're doing is we're celebrating this date, 20 years, and it's at the World Famous Comedy Store, 10 p.m. Now, pre-sale tickets are $10. They're $15 the day of the show. But we just opened this up this past week. There's going to be some special VIP seating. Now, I want you to hear this because this is what's really cool. Anybody who gets VIP seating, here's what you get. We ask for donations. Now, the donation, it has to be at least $100. If you make that donation, what you will get, you'll get two DVDs of never-before-seen Big 3 stuff. And I'm telling you, it's good. You'll get an audio CD specially made for this event. The only people that get that are the people that give a $100 donation for the VIP donation tickets. Now, you donate at least $100. But here's the real crazy thing. The person that donates the most, we ask for at least $100. But the person that donates the most, let's say you have two people and you want to give $1,000 for a donation. And that's the most that anybody does. Here's what you get. You still get all the CDs, the DVDs, the T-shirts. You will also receive a day that you will never forget. Because on the day of the show, you will start out. You'll be picked up by a minivan. You'll be taken to Perry's apartment for a spaghetti lunch. You'll get to go into Perry's apartment, take pictures in there. You will have the lunch by the pool. Then you will be whisked away. You'll be taken to the Comedy Store where you'll get a chance to watch the rehearsal. Then after the rehearsal, you will come with me to my job. You will get a chance to see a show. You will see that entire show. Then we will come back to the Comedy Store for your VIP seating. You will actually, when we are at rehearsal, you will choose where you want to sit. When you come back, you will be whisked to your seats. Then you will get a chance to see the show. You will be given backstage passes for after the show. That's for the person that donates the most. So if you want to get your special VIP sponsorship seating, you donate $100, you get a bunch of cool stuff. But if you get the biggest and the highest donation, you get that little extra. That's on June 25th. Now, when you send for your tickets, you must include your email address or another way to get in touch with you. After receiving your ticket, then the day of the show for anybody else who buys a ticket, pre-sale, you will come the day of the show. You will get your souvenir ticket. That's pretty cool. A cool front and back design. You will do that the day of the show at this Comedy Store box office. And that's where you'll get it. So that's for our big holiday show. Are you getting excited about that? That's just a few weeks away, Perry.
Few weeks, less than that.
Yeah, I know. Well, listen, you know, what we do on this show, we are a show that, you know, and when I say we are a show that does this, there's been many imitators since then, but we are a show that our main interest is talking about pop culture and our own personal lives. And what we do beyond that is we give the audience, the fans, a chance to talk to us, to send us kind of a shout out. And that's why we have our $10 shout out.
$10 shout out.
Now, if you've never heard the show before, what we do is we have a $10 shout out. You send $10 cash. That's no checks, no money orders, straight cash, homie. You send it to 7510 Sunset Boulevard, number 153. You address it to $10 shoutouts, care of Don Barris. That's Hollywood, California, 90046. So we have some $10 shoutouts. Here's the first one. Dear Big Three, I love the podcast because you talk about pop culture and your own personal lives. Don and Mola are always great and have a new and interesting stories for each show. But I sometimes think Perry Caramello speaks too much about his personal life. By the way, I have a cold, so I'm losing my voice. We all know the many ladies that Mole and Don have pleased throughout the years, but do we ever hear them interrupt Perry in the middle of his stories to brag about those legendary woman-pleasing tales? No, we don't. They're too modest to do that. Perry, on the other hand, cannot wait for the podcast to begin bragging about sucking Randy Callahan's cock.
Fuck!
Yeah. Again, here's exactly what I was saying a little bit earlier. Perry did not suck Randy Callahan's dick! And it went on to say, and drinking his cum like a milkshake. Anyway, we get it, Perry. You love cock. What else is going to go on your personal life?
I love Playboy penthouse women. Like Linda Johnson.
Okay, let me just finish this. On one
Victoria Givens.
Let me just finish this.
Fuck.
On one podcast, I thought I heard Perry say he jerked off Randy Callahan's feet and licked them clean. Can you confirm this, Perry? Did you ever say that?
Licked what?
That you jerked off Randy Callahan's dick and the cum went on Randy Callahan's feet and you licked them off.
Fuck off.
That's what I thought. No, he did not do that. I guess it was worth it, though. That's why we're thankful for the experience with Randy and you've been on your 20-year success ride. Thanks, Big Three. Cole from Iowa.
Again, people don't understand. I got in fucking trouble. I was being real sweet and cool to this one chick. Then I went to give her a goodbye kiss, and she fucking turned me in. Oops.
Okay, we got another $10 shout. Dear Perry, everyone is excited about the big anniversary celebration on the 25th. But there's another celebration that is coming up, and we need to start planning for that as well.
February. Yeah, Terry's birthday.
When's that?
I think it's 23rd.
Well, he's not talking about that. Oh. He's talking about February 7th is Randy Callahan's birthday.
Fuck him.
And next February, he will be 60 years old.
Big fucking deal.
A group of friends, including myself, are starting to plan Randy's big 60th.
Which Randy? Some other Randy that I don't know?
I think he's talking about Randy Callahan.
I don't know.
But it isn't going to be much of a party unless we can get the Scaremaster to attend.
Fuck off.
We'd also like you to perform there, and we'll pay you handsomely. Wait a second. Do you want me to go on?
Keep reading.
Okay. Our plan is to have a giant cake, which you will then jump out wearing nothing but a G-string and a party hat. We will crank up AC/DC's You Shook Me All Night Long, and you can do some sexy dance moves around for Randy. You know, shake your ass, tease him a little bit.
How many billions of dollars do they plan on paying?
Well, do you want me to read on, or do you want to keep interrupting? After that, we'll bring out the cake, and you will sing Happy Birthday for Randy the same way Marilyn Monroe did for JFK. Could you do that? Happy birthday.
Oh, God.
How does that go, Mary Jane?
I don't know.
Let Mary Jane.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mr. President.
Which will probably be replaced for Randy Callahan.
Happy birthday to you.
I don't sing like that.
Okay, anyway, he goes on. Do you want me to read this or no?
Go on.
Okay. Randy also requested that he be allowed to eat the birthday cake off your penis, but I thought that was too much. Although if you could give him a little extra frosting on the cake for him, I'm sure he'd appreciate it. As you can see, you stand to make a lot of money, although we can give you a lot more if you stay at the party and do some private performances for Randy and friends. Just name your price, and we'll see what you can do. Your friend, Dimitri Moreland.
This Dimitri fucking guy is a jag-off beyond belief, one.
All right.
I'm going to make sure I delete him from all my sites, all too. Right.
As a business person.
Three. Okay. As a business person, he should no longer have any contact with me in any way, shape, or form.
Well, I'm just saying, as a business person, he's saying name your price.
Name my price?
That's what he said.
$50 trillion.
Would you be willing to go lower than $50
trillion? All right. $999 billion.
Okay, well, there's your price. All right, here we have another $10 shout-out. This is Dear Big Three. Perry is not a skateboard enthusiast.
What?
He's overweight, out of shape, and severely handicapped. There's no way he's ever done a 720 on a half pipe or a Willy Wonka up a tree. Have you done
it?
Okay, so he's right on that. Perry claims that he has his own factory which manufactures his own line of skateboards, but everyone knows this is a lie. Perry is a poor and a bit of a loser. How could someone living on a dole own a factory? This makes no sense.
I don't own the factory. Okay? And a lot of different designs.
Okay, but what he's saying
here... A lot of different companies are all made at the same company.
Let me read what he's saying here. And don't say you contract a factory, Perry, because that is only slightly less unbelievable. You show off skateboards made by someone else, and you slap on a Scary Perry sticker to claim that it is your own. Pathetic.
I don't put a sticker on my board.
Let me just finish this, okay? Terrifying Tim is a true skateboard enthusiast.
Oh, God, he's a waste of my fucking time. He's a fucking China wannabe. There's no Terrifying Tim skateboards on the fucking market anywhere.
Well, that's not true. Why does everybody know about them then? Because you don't have one?
I don't have one.
Let me read on.
I wouldn't own one.
Let me read on. Let me read on!
Show me a Terrifying Tim skateboard deck.
Okay.
Other than what's on the internet, which is just an internet picture.
May I finish?
Read.
Did you just belch?
Excuse me.
Okay. His skateboards are superior to everything on the market, including Perry's fairy tale boards. He pays little children good money over in China that would otherwise have to work as prostitutes. Well, you know, I never looked at it that way. He pays these kids good money.
Whatever.
If they weren't working in a skateboard factory, they would be prostitutes. So their small fingers enable them to make far better boards than any American board made by banana hands under our labor protection laws. Big Three fans, please join me celebrating a true American hero. Thank you, and God bless Terrifying Tim. This is from Brian.
Terrifying Tim is a human waste. One, Terrifying Tim is not even his real name.
Okay, let me just say this.
Tim Perpetic is a fake.
No, it is not. It's not a fake.
Show me his ID.
I don't have his ID here.
I want to see his fucking driver's license.
Well, obviously, his name isn't Terrifying Tim. Is yours Scary Perry?
Mine is Perry Caravello.
But is it Scary Perry?
Scary Perry is my
stage name.
No, it's
not. Well, that's his stage name, Terrifying Tim. Okay, we have one last Big Three shout-out. Dear Big Three, I'm writing to let all your fans know about the experience I had purchased one of Terrifying Tim's skateboards. See, here's another guy. So don't
lie.
Okay, it's not a lie. These guys are sending them. I bought one of his made-in-China skateboards a few months ago. On my first attempt to ride it, it broke in half. Now, you're laughing about that.
Yeah, because I told you his boards are shit.
I fell
if
in
they're
it.
Real.
Okay. Now that it breaks, it's real. I fell and hurt my back. I was rushed to the hospital and put in traction. At the time, I am currently unable to move my arms or legs. However, the doctors say I may gain mobility if I have a series of expensive surgeries. I guess I fell for the Tim Slick viral marketing techniques and his ridiculing of his competitors. Although I am a big fan of America and applaud Terrifying Tim's heroic contributions to catching Bin Laden, I now realize that I should have purchased one of Perry's Canadian skateboards made with genuine hardwood, no matter what Tim says about them. So has Tim put you down, do you know?
I have no idea.
In order to pay for my operations and ongoing medical bills, I was able to get a job sweeping the hallways of an office building by attaching a broom to my wheelchair that I can maneuver around by blowing it into a tube. Oh, this is sad. I want to be able to earn a living on my own because I know that's what Terrifying Tim would do if he was in my situations. Besides, everyone knows that the only thing on planet Earth that is lower than an Italian is someone who is fully able to work but claims disability. Evil Steve in Seattle. See, in some ways, I think that's kind of a jab at you.
That's a crock of shit.
Anyway, that was today's $10 shout-outs.
$10 shout-out!
Wait a second. Is that a phone call? Why don't you send that call through for us, please?
Hey now, don't dream it's over.
Oh, hello, Mr. Adams.
Who's this?
Listen, this is a rather unorthodox podcast, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess it is, kind of.
Perry, you guess why this podcast is different from all others?
Number one, there's no mole.
May I do something here? May I introduce someone? Please pick up the phone, Wally. Pick it up.
Who's Wally?
Hello?
Mole, what are you doing at Quincy's place?
Hey, Dan, yeah, I came by to snag some of his kick-ass back pills. What are you doing?
Oh, we're doing the podcast, Mole.
You're supposed to be here, asshole.
Yes, we are, Mole.
You're supposed to be here.
The podcast, where's my best pal, Perry?
You're supposed to be here.
Perry, hold on. Be quiet for a second. I'm trying to ask Dan a question. Where's my best pal, Perry?
He's right over here. He's just talking to you.
Hey, Scaremaster.
Hey, Mole, you still getting high with Quincy?
Mole, you missed the podcast.
You're supposed to be fucking here, dumb fuck.
Early. Oh, so when you were talking about, when you said we were taping it a day early, that's what you meant by a day early.
We're going to need to talk about your professionalism, Mole.
You know what I think we should talk about? You know what I think we should talk about right now? Hey, Mr. Adams, pick up your phone. Pick it up. Walter, did you leave me an upper decker, you rascal? Maybe. I love it. I love it. And for that, you get a rib tickler. Listen, what does Cinderella wear to scuba dive? Yeah, tell him, Scaremaster. Tell him.
What does Cinderella...
Tell him, dude. Cinderella, scuba dive, glass flippers. Jesus. You got it.
I don't know.
He certainly does got it, yes. Good morrow, gents. Hey, listen, don't start the show without me. I'll be right there, okay?
We've already started it, Mole.
I'm on my way. Later, dudes.
Mole, call us back when you're away from Adams, okay? That was John Quincy Adams, and that was Mole. What the fuck?
What a dick.
I told him that we were going to do the show a day early because we sometimes
he's fucking smoking too much, okay?
You think so?
He's smoking way too much. He's got no... the guy's bright, but he's fucking dumb bright.
What do you mean by that exactly?
He's a smart ass, and he's way too fucking high, hey.
He doesn't do that.
What, he doesn't smoke dope? He smokes like 10 times more than you do, and you get high a lot.
Perry, that's accusing me of something that I've never done in my life.
Liar!
I have never...
That's a lie! I can look you in the eye and say that's a lie! You smoke pot, he smokes pot, she smokes pot, y'all smoke dope.
Well, I have a medical marijuana license, so I think you
should. So does she.
It's illegal.
So does she.
Well, you know what? Then maybe what we should do is talk about what happened in court. Why can't you tell us one thing that happened?
Because for the fans. Because they said it's not
Who
allowed.
Said? Who
the
said?
The courts.
The courts don't listen to this show.
I'm not allowed to talk about what goes
Why?
On.
What happened? Is it good for you?
Well, if I bring it up, it'll fuck me up.
How will it fuck you up? Just explain that.
Period.
Then we'll leave it alone. We'll leave it alone. How will it fuck you up?
I'm just not allowed to talk about it.
Why?
Because.
Because why?
I just said so.
Jeez. Oh, is that another call? Send that call through for us, please. If it's Mole calling back, I'll bet.
Hey, dude, you know who it is?
Yeah, it's Mole.
Where you at, motherfucker?
It's Mole. Hey, did you guys start the show yet?
Yes, Duh. Mole. We're doing it now.
Who the fuck are you, douchebag?
You doing right now? If you're doing it right now, where's my best pal, Perry?
I'm right here,
we
stupid.
We did this already, Mole. Yeah.
Dude, listen. I got to tell you, this whole thing, I think it's at least partially my fault. I also kind of think it's
partially, it's all your fault.
I
knocked over the table.
I had to set up my iCalendar on my phone, and You what? Never touched base with me before the show for our pep talk.
You guys used to do that?
No, we never did that.
No, no, we didn't.
You never
it
even...
It would have been cool.
Hey, how about this
that.
One?
Anyway, listen, I'll see you do...
When are you going to invite me over to your house?
Later, no, dudes. No, Mole, you can't... He hung up. He is brain dead.
He is definitely stupid.
I think he lives near the marina, so he's never going to make it in time. Never, ever, ever.
What, he lives in Culver City?
All right, so, no, I don't know where John Adams lives, but I do know this. I have a little bone to pick with you. And since you won't tell us anything about your family matters, since you won't, just all the fans do is they care about you. They want to know what's going on.
Well, see, I'm not legally allowed, so okay. I can't talk about it.
Who told you that? The judge?
The judge.
What do judges know?
The judge knows who I am. The judge knows that what's going on in my life.
Okay. So instead of doing that, why don't we do this? Because this is a little bone I got to pick with you. I don't know if you remember like a 15-year-old kid and a 13-year-old kid that were fucking with you.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's just say I took care of the problem.
I know.
Okay. Well, they had a bunch of tapes, Perry. I listened to these tapes. I want to play a segment of one of those tapes right now. Could you play that tape for me, please?
Just 1 second. John, I'm really not feeling good, but I just want to tell you one thing. They told me that someone called you and offered you a movie and said that we're in cahoots against you.
Yes.
Let me get the guy's number who said this, okay?
I can't give away a number.
It's your voice.
I'm not giving anybody's phone number.
Absolutely not.
Do not tell him how you got the number.
No, I would never do that, Perry. Absolutely.
Just say you got it through Jimmy Kimmel Live.
Huh.
Yeah. Absolutely.
You got it at Jimmy Kimmel. You called Jimmy Kimmel Live and they gave it to you. Okay?
Yeah.
That's how you get it. 3, 2, 3. You got Don's number through Jimmy Kimmel Live. Yes, period.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
I'm sorry.
You fucking pile of shit is my first thought. You fucking pile of shit. I'm trying to do something for your dumb ass, and this is the way you treat me.
I know.
Well, there's a few things that I could do. I could beat the fuck out of your pussy ass for doing that, but then you would go and you'd have your little fucking lawyer fuck with me. So I can't do that, can I, Perry? Even though I'd like to pound the fuck out of you. Nobody's ever done anything for you. I'm the only... You're I put you in a fucking movie, you dope.
Yeah.
You dodo bird. A long time ago. Has anyone done anything since?
Nothing good.
You know what? You had the door open because of me, and you couldn't do anything else. Don't fucking say because it's a long time ago. We have a big show that you're going to make money on June 25th, just a couple weeks away. So here's what I'm going to do.
Yes, sir.
I brought in somebody today that'd like to talk to you. Is it a mafiosa guy? No. It's a therapist. I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Tommy Morris. Come on in here.
Good to be here. How are you?
Why don't you put on your headphones?
These on here. Woo! How are you, Terry?
Perry Caravello. And you're a therapist.
Yeah.
Who gave you a license to be a therapist?
Perry, shut your fucking mouth.
No.
Shut your fucking mouth. You gave out my motherfucking number. So I brought in a guy to talk to you because there's something really fucked up in your head, dude.
Perry, you could put a roller snake on top of a roller coaster, but when it comes off, it ain't gonna bake you a cake. Okay? These are facts.
Whatever.
Hey, excuse me, Dr. Morris, can you talk a little closer to the mic?
Check one, check two.
Okay.
Now I'm riled up.
Okay.
It's nice in here, though.
It is nice.
I read over a lot about you, Terry.
You probably read a bunch of bullshit, but go on.
No, these are facts from Don.
Well, let me just tell you again what happened here. A 13-year-old and a 15-year-old fooled Perry into believing that he was going to star in a movie. They told him that he's got to drop his manager and quit the show. What a fucking moron.
Bunch of bullshit. I know.
He got fooled by a 13-year-old and a 15-year-old.
Let me look through my notes.
What stood out there more than anything else?
What's standing out to me is one name, and that is Randy Callahan.
What about him?
What does that mean?
That was something that happened 20 years ago. I did fucking...
Well, a lot of things...
Shut the fuck up, and I'll tell you...
Perry, don't tell me to shut up! Don't tell the therapist to shut up!
He's a nobody!
He's not a nobody! You wait, hold on.
I went to the University of Idaho, friendly.
How many years?
Dr. Morris, stop right there. Dr. Morris, don't answer a question.
See
ya. Perry, shut your...
What'd you do, fail the first two?
Perry! What the fuck are you talking about? First of all, any fucking fool knows you go to undergraduate school, then you go to medical school.
And I also went to physical therapy school, so I could fix your elbow if I wanted to.
We're not here for that. What we're here for is for you to kind of talk to this guy a little bit. Say you're sorry for screaming
at him. I'm sorry.
For what?
For yelling.
Okay, now you were talking about Randy Callahan.
Now, you know... You guys better drop this bullshit.
I'm not.
Because, look, what happened to me 20 years ago was a fucking thing that happened on a film set that I got in trouble. Well, not, it didn't happen.
We know what happened.
Look, I was leaving
Perry,
the fucking place.
Perry, why do you got to brag about this constantly?
I'm not bragging. Just I'm fucking complaining.
Just because you sucked another man.
I didn't
penis.
Suck anybody's dick,
okay,
you
see,
fag.
Okay, see, hold on. He's not a fag. He's a doctor. All right, number one.
I don't do that.
Dr. Morris, if I may say this. He did not suck a penis, and that's something that I think may have affected him.
Well, whether he put it in his mouth for a little bit.
No, he didn't do that.
I didn't put any
What he did. Let me explain it, Perry, because you seem a little off the edge. What he did is this. He was new to the business, and some guy threatened him and said he'd kick him out of show business. So the guy blew Perry, and he jerked him off. All these guys say that he blew him. You did not blow anybody.
Didn't blow anybody.
I'm tired of hearing this bullshit. People, stop it. Dr. Morris, he did not blow anybody. You're welcome.
Where'd the cum go?
What are you talking about?
Where did the cum go when you ejaculated?
When I ejaculated?
Yeah.
Down his throat? Down his throat.
Okay.
I'd like to just, if you don't mind me, a lot of times when I do my therapy, I use a Dr. Phil voice.
Oh, is that what that was?
Just so I can connect with you and so we could bring the walls down. Do you permission to use my own voice?
Yeah, I think it's
please.
Cool.
Okay. Terry, when I look at you...
Perry,
when I look at you, you know, I see a man who's... The hair on his forehead is protruding.
So?
Okay.
You got a problem?
No. I'm just saying, I can read that, and I can see that, and I can say something about you from that.
Dr. Morris, how will we get him to stop blowing his opportunity? We have a show that is on the 25th of this month, and what we're trying to do is we're trying to get to that, but Perry keeps sabotaging himself. How can we talk to him so he can realize, hey, maybe I shouldn't be so tough on Don. Don really is a good guy.
Well, I think the first thing that needs to happen is, Perry, you have to look at me in the eyes for a second. Can you see my eyes?
Yeah, I can.
And what do you see in my eyes?
Glasses.
No, in my eyes.
I don't know.
Okay. I can learn a lot by playing a game with someone. So would you like to play a game right now?
Like?
I know what we could do.
What's that?
We could go into a little guy talk. This is something that we do on the show. It's where we just talk about guys and things like that.
Because I think games are fun, and games enable you to get a little farther from the ego and into the realm of where are we, what are we looking at, and how can we progress?
Well, this guy talk game is a good one, because what this does is this. This is where three guys today sitting around talking about the ladies. It's time once again for a little guy talk.
Oh yeah, it's guy talk. Gonna talk about the ladies. Guy talk.
Ooh. Alright, now since you've never been here before, what we do during guy talk, we'll just tell stories about ladies and things like that. Maybe you can get some information from that kind of game.
Okay.
Alright, now Perry talks about all these women that he's been with, but they're usually like penthouse centerfolds and things like that, that he paid a couple times to have sex with. Did you ever have sex with any of these girls without paying?
Yeah, I've been with Linda.
Linda.
Several times without paying.
Without paying. What did she do to you?
We made love.
What do you mean making love? Like, what kind of sex?
Missionary.
Missionary. Did you eat her ass?
I'm not in that fucking putting poop peanuts in my mouth.
Poop peanuts. Well, that's somebody's shit. You ever heard of a washcloth?
You're sick.
I'm sick. That's why you don't have girls.
I've eaten.
That's why you don't have girls.
You're not a woman. Oh, God. To explore. Give me a fucking break.
Go ahead, Dr. Morris.
To explore the human body and the calculations that human thought can be held within.
Girls.
You know.
You're sick.
Did she eat your ass?
No comment.
What did she do, Perry?
We fucked, okay?
That's it? Just missionary fuck?
Several times, yes.
Did you eat her vagina?
Yes.
Are you any good at that?
I'm very good at that.
Okay. Where's the kibastopinus?
Where's the who?
Kibastopinus.
You mean the say that again?
No, I've said it twice.
The kibastopinus?
Have you ever explored that on a woman?
You mean inside?
Yes.
Yes.
Where is it?
You reach in, it's right there.
No, that's not it.
Are you you're thinking about the
the kibastopinus?
Oh shit! No, there's like a G spot.
Okay, we're not talking about the G spot.
What's a kibastopinus? What is a kibastopinus?
Dr. Morris, you know what that is, correct?
Of course, okay. I know what that is.
So you've never dealt with that with a woman.
I don't even know the word.
Okay, so this is a problem that as a man...
So you answered a question that you didn't know the answer to.
No, right. Okay. I mean, just mess with the guy. I'm very good at that.
I think, though, by looking at you, Perry, and taking on your mannerisms, I can see a lot to you that we don't already know.
Fine.
Do you think he's gay?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Get the fuck out of here now, okay, motherfucker.
Wait, no, Perry.
I'm happy gay.
Perry.
I'm proud gay. I'm not faggot gay, motherfucker.
You're in my own approximations. You are cum-guzzling gay, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I don't think you should worry about it. But you are that, I think, yes.
Do you think he's
You can kiss my motherfucking ass.
Well, Perry, if I were to do that, there would probably be cum all over it, and I would risk infection or other disease.
Okay, Perry, we brought this guy in just to observe. Now, you can't fucking swear at him because these are his thoughts. Why do you think he's gay?
Again, if you look at the forehead and the protruding...
You know what, motherfucker? Go fuck yourself.
Don't tell...
No, he's a fucking complete faggot, and I don't want to ever talk to him again.
What do you mean by complete faggot? You mean I have the house, the car, the furry little animal? What do you mean?
You're a homosexual, and I can't stand you. Don't talk to me again. Period.
He's a therapist.
He's not a therapist. He's a fucking waste of my time. I only talk to you now, or her.
Okay.
She's a lady. You're my fucking comedian business associate.
Okay, so if you have a question for him, you'll ask me, and then I'll ask him.
All right. Can you ask Terry to put his hand on top of his forehead?
Perry, would you put your hand on top of your forehead?
Now, would you please ask him to put his other hand under his chin? Let's try that.
Okay. Perry, would you put your other hand underneath your chin?
Like this?
Like that?
That looks pretty good.
Okay. Now, what does that tell you?
Ask him what is going through his mind right now.
What is going through your mind at this exact second?
I feel like I'm doing something really stupid.
Put your hand there. Put him back. Okay. All right. Jesus, he feels Christ. Like it's really stupid.
If he was to open up his mouth as far as it goes... Can you ask him to do that?
Open up your mouth as far as it can open.
Okay. Let him know that just about any cock would fit in there.
Guess what, faggot? No cock is going to go in there.
Yeah, but I'm saying it would and it could.
Guess what, motherfucker? Eat my fucking ass! You fucking fag! I'm going to beat your fucking head in!
Harry, you have a broken...
I'm going to break him in two!
No, why? Because
he's a cocksucker! He's a fucking homosexual! And I don't want nothing to do with them.
Technically, you would be the cocksucker if you kept.
No, technically, I'll break you and fuck
Perry,
it down.
Stop threatening people.
Threatening? I'm gonna
Perry,
kill the son of a bitch.
I brought him in here because
you brought him in here because he's a fucking homo. He wants to suck my dick,
that
and
is
you think
not
you want to
reason.
Make and you're trying to make
reason.
Me a fucking.
No, I'm not.
Down.
You throw that bottle at me, and I don't give a fuck. You gave my number to another person.
Oh Christ,
Perry, you're trying to ruin.
You always give my number out.
I don't do that at all.
Bullshit.
You have it on the internet, you
it's
fucking
It's no longer
pilot.
There.
All right, but everybody has it. Don't blame me for your stupidity. I brought it. I don't know if this is working. I just don't know if
it's
working.
Not working. This guy's a homosexual.
All right.
And he wants to make me a homosexual. Why do I think you're gay? Oh, open your mouth. Oh, a dick can fit in their mouth. Oh, he could swallow what he puts in his mouth.
He didn't say that.
I didn't say that, first off. I'm saying you're exploring your own explorations.
Look, I'm not interested in gay shit. Look, I don't believe in that faggot stuff. Look,
what about
my
Andy
religious...
Callahan?
Randy Callahan guy got in trouble. That was my fucking boss, you sick fuck. What? He was my fucking casting director, you motherfucker. I got in trouble leaving a film set. God damn it, I have to explain this for 20 fucking years. Go fuck yourself.
All right.
Get the fuck out of my studio!
Perry, it's not your studio.
This is my fucking place!
This isn't your
place. Get out of here now!
Perry, settle down. Settle down. You're acting irrational right now.
And give me all that fucking money!
You're not getting all the fucking money. Who the fuck do you think you are? Shut your fucking mouth and... Wait a minute. I'm going to keep all the money for you fucking giving up my phone number. What about that, you pile of dog?
How about this, prick? How about the fucking 25th? I don't show. Nick doesn't show.
No.
Nobody comes to my place.
Then you lose.
There's no fucking food that's going to be served to anybody.
Settle down, psycho boy. Then what you do is you lose a lot of money that day.
Like what kind of money am I going to lose? Because I got all these faggots that are fucking pushing me and ready to make me explode.
Who's the faggot pushing you?
This cocksucker, number one.
Dr. Tommy Morris, are you?
Cock. I've had my cock sucked, but it's never been me sucking.
I got in trouble.
All right, let's everybody settle down. I think we're getting out of hand. Mary Jane.
I think I know what's wrong.
What?
Perry had said that he hadn't eaten anything yet today. He seems maybe temperamental for blood
sugar.
What the heck could fix that?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Would you, for the time being, would you like some sunflower kernels?
I think it would be in your best
interest. I'm fine.
Okay, everybody, let's settle down. Perry, please, just for one second. I don't think this guy talk works, so let's just close it out. And that was today's Guy Talk.
Oh, yeah. It's Guy Talk. Ooh.
Dr. Morris, I'm
sorry. I'm not a faggot.
No, okay,
I will
stop.
Never be a faggot.
Stop.
I will not
Perry.
Allow
Perry.
Faggots in my life.
Hold on, Dr. Morris.
Technically, the moment a cock enters your mouth, you are a faggot.
Technically, the moment a cock will never enter my mouth.
Okay,
one
everybody.
Moment.
Perry,
cocks
you're
will never enter my fucking facility. Two, number three, you're going to get the fuck out of this place. Or I'm going to come out here and beat your fucking ass.
All right.
You and skip. I have no fucking
Perry,
strength.
Perry, you skip number two, number one, and I'm going to say this. Let's mellow the fuck out, everybody.
I
Perry.
I don't think these mics can take that sort of...
Hey, Dr. Morris, let me straighten this out. Just hold on. Perry, take a deep breath. Let it out through the mouth. Through the nose?
No.
I'm trying to... Let's settle down. Perry, you can't go through this.
You look.
All right, let's not talk about
he's
this.
He's not to talk to me ever
first
again.
First off, I would appreciate you not pointing your finger at me. I'm a doctor.
You're a dick. You want my
Perry,
fucking mouth to
Perry.
Suck on it like I'm a faggot. That is not going to happen.
All right, let's just mellow out for 1 second. Everything's going to be okay. Perry, we're trying to promote a show. I thought I'd bring this doctor in to... Perry, listen. Just listen. Just listen. I thought if I brought Dr. Tommy Morris in here, I thought that everything would mellow you out. It has not worked that way. But you see, you can't give out my phone number.
I'm sorry.
All right.
How many fucking times do I got to say I'm sorry?
But Perry, you do
I
it.
Know. I look,
Perry,
I know what
down.
I did was wrong. I apologize to my business manager, Nick. I know what I did was wrong. I apologize to you over the phone. I know what I did was fucking wrong. I was completely fucking wrong. These two little bastards deserved what they got. I was wrong. Okay?
Okay. All right. All right. All right. Settle down.
Forgive me for giving away your fucking whatever the fuck I gave away.
Okay, Perry. You've got to relax. Settle down. Now, speaking of great ways to relax, for me personally, I find the best way is by eating great Thai food. And for myself and for the listeners of this podcast, when we're looking for the finest in Thai cuisine, where do we go? What the Huck? 323-654-7952. You like Thai food, don't you, Doctor?
It's delicious, but sometimes it can pay a toll on your colon.
I did not know that.
Yeah. Oh, God.
It depends how much water you consume before.
Is water good or bad for
absolutely it? Good to flush out the salt and some of the other enzymes. Hmm. But I think that's common knowledge.
All right, but we're not talking about that. What is the number again, Perry?
No. Excuse me. 323-654-7952.
Here's a guy right off the street. Hi, what's your name, sir?
Hi, I'm Perry.
And have you ever had What the Huck?
Their food is delicious.
That's right. For the finest in Thai cuisine, it's What the Huck. 323-654-7952. You know what? We got one last commercial to do, and are you going to flip out because we have to use Terrifying Tim's voice in this?
Go right ahead.
Okay. ASM Plumbing and Porn is your one stop for all your plumbing and your hardcore man-on-man porn concerns. That's ASM Plumbing and Porn, 440-731-9338. Now, you have a very nice voice, and I saw that you did a Dr. Phil impression. Do you do any other impressions?
I do a few. I like to tinker. I like, it's one of my things.
Like, who could you do? Who's a good one?
Oh, geez. Dustin Hoffman?
All right, well, why don't you read this right from there as Dustin Hoffman?
But don't take my word for it. Why not listen to the words and wisdom of an American hero and good friend of the show, skateboarding enthusiast, Terrifying Tim Terpedic.
Hi, I'm Terrifying Tim for ASM Plumbing and Porn. You want hot man-on-man films and top-notch plumbing and piping? Call ASM! Now, I may not be nearly as gay as their last spokesman, but I do know quality cornholing when I see it. Let's unclog some pipes! Ooh, 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 ooh! ASM Plumbing and Porn. Tell them Terrifying Tim sent you. Ooh, 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 ooh!
That's ASM Plumbing and Porn, 440-731-9338.
Sound like more like Dustin Hoffman in
that's, what was the name of that? That's who he was doing.
At least I don't suck guys' dicks.
I'm going to fucking put my fist
Perry,
on your throat.
Dr. Morris, please.
You're going to lose a few teeth by the time I walk the fuck
I'm
out of here.
I'm a doctor and I don't suck guys.
All right, Perry, he didn't...
Mess with me, I'll mess with you.
Dr. Morris, hold on just for a second. May I say something to you, please? He did not suck a penis, and I thought it was a good Dustin Hoffman. Perry, I think you're a little bit out of line today.
I'm a little out of line?
Yeah.
This piece of shit over here has no right saying that I'm...
This piece of shit over here has no right!
Perry, sit down!
Perry, sit down.
I'm
going to
knock you down. Perry, sit down. Sit down.
Perry, you don't hit a doctor. You
Perry,
can't afford
sit
the
down.
Fucking...
Just sit down.
You technically do not hit a doctor.
Please sit down. Please just sit down. Please sit down.
Perry, it's just a test to see where you're at mentally, hearing your own voice.
Do you think he proved that he's not gay by...
Let me use the restroom.
No, we're in the middle of a show. We're almost done. Can we just forgive? Will you say you're sorry to Perry, please, Dr. Tommy Morris?
I'm sorry.
Perry?
For?
Calling you the homo that you are.
All right, now you say you accept it, and you apologize for yelling at him.
Calling me the homo that I am?
Well, how
excuse
do you
me?
Want to quantify it?
Wait a second.
Wait a second. All right, Dr. Morris, do you understand why you're pushing buttons now?
I just...
You're kind of pushing his
you're
button.
You're an asshole.
I love to
you've
impersonate.
Got nothing in common with
you
me, doctor. You're a fucking fake. You're not
right,
even a fucking
stop,
doctor.
Stop.
You're a lying piece of shit.
Stop.
You're a fucking homosexual
Perry,
fuck.
Stop.
You want me to be a fucking faggot?
Perry!
Fuck
Perry,
you too!
Shut up! Don't tell me to fuck off. Shut up! I'm trying to be your friend. He never sucked a dick. And Dr. Morris, you're out of line for saying that. Am I right, Perry?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, here's what we're going to do. We're going to try one other thing. We're going to try a little mole play.
Mole play, mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play, mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play!
If you've never heard mole play before, when Mole is here, what he will do is he'll set up a scene, he'll direct the scene, he'll cast the scene. Now, usually, it's Mole will make up something on the spot, what happened during the day, or something from the local paper, maybe a headline. Now, I will take Mole's position today, and we will act out a scene, okay? But what I see, now you do impressions, right, Dr. Tommy Morris?
I like to fancy myself.
All right, and Perry does some impressions. Show him your Wolfman Jack.
That's right, baby. I do the best Wolfman Jack you could
okay,
ever think of.
Do Jimmy Gnatowski.
Oh, what are you looking for? You want to... Want me to clean the carburetor?
Okay, do Jack Carter.
Jack Carter? How you doing? Good to see you.
Who's
My name
Jack
is Jack
Carter.
Jack Carter was an old radio announcer back in the 50s.
No, he was a stand-up comic
and
in the 60s and the 70s.
And a comedian back in the mid-60s.
He was never a radio announcer. Okay, so you're wrong. You're
okay, he was a comedian.
All right,
back
anyway,
in
the point is, who else can you do? Just so I can get an idea.
I can do a little Gary Busey.
Let's hear your Gary Busey.
AIDS walk. You can't walk AIDS off. You got to run it off.
Okay. That's very good. Who else can you do?
I can do Louis Anderson.
Let's hear that.
You guys ready to play the feud? Got time here. That 5 minutes on the bar was serving 1,000 million people.
That's not Louis Anderson.
I want to suck Barry's dick.
I thought so. You're a faggot.
Perry,
You'd
he's doing
me.
An impression.
You're a faggot.
You'd
he's doing
me.
An impression.
Whatever.
All right, so here's what today's mole play is going to be.
Cocksucker.
All right, we're all in a coffee shop, but here's the people. Louis Anderson is there. David Letterman is there. Wolfman Jack is there. Jim Gnatowski is there. Mary Jane, you'll be playing a damsel in distress.
Okay.
And I am promoting the show on June 25th for the big show at the Comedy Store at 10 p.m. All right? And it's Mole Play. Hey, wow, a lot of celebrities there. Hey, are you Louis Anderson?
Yeah, I'm Louis Anderson.
Me.
Are you Wolfman Jack?
Hey, man, I've been Wolfman and I've been, I've been everybody you can think of.
Yeah.
Well, first off, there's something open.
Wolfman, can I ask you this? Behind you, is that Bugs Bunny?
Wee. What's up, Doc?
It is Bugs Bunny.
Hey, geez. It's me, David Letterman. How's it going?
Hey, listen, I was wondering, could I come on your show? Because I'm trying to promote a big show at the Comedy Store on June 25th. Now, this show, we're going to be doing two podcasts that night of the Big Three podcasts. I don't know if you've ever heard of them.
Yeah, I've heard of it. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, it's with my friend Perry, who's right
over
here.
I say, there's a big show
wait
going on over there at their store over there, and I say the Yosemite Sam and
what's your name?
I forgot my name there.
Okay, could you do me a favor and shut the fuck up? I'm talking to Perry over there. Perry's in the show, and we have another guy by the name of Mole.
Hey,
right,
Perry?
Nice
to see you. Good to have you here. I'm a big fan.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyway.
You like to come on my show? You like to come on my show?
Whose show?
David Letterman show.
Oh, you want to fly me to New York, Letterman?
Yeah, what I really like to do is eat your ass. I like to suck on that big fucking ball of yours.
Okay.
Hey,
David.
Ball.
You want my foot down
Perry,
your throat,
Perry.
You cocksucker?
Yeah, put your foot down my foot and come all over my neck, you cocksucker.
Help! Help! There's a wolf trying to attack me! Help!
Oh. Hey, wait a second here. I got my hands around the lady's neck.
Hey, Wolfman.
It smells!
Wolfman, why don't you come too?
Why don't you come on over to me?
I want to talk to you guys about this show.
Hello?
Now, it's $10 to pre-order the tickets, $15 a day of the show, and there's that very special VIP sponsor ticket that you can get with a donation of $100 or more. If you donate the highest, though, you will get a prize package unlike anything, including a lunch over at Perry's apartment. But that's how we're... So this is going
to
be...
I'm hungry. That's making me hungry.
That man ain't going to be coming over to the Scam Master's joint. Not at all, baby.
Who's this?
This guy right in front of me here. He ain't coming over to that...
My name's Louis Anderson.
No, your name's going to be...
$1,000. I think we could have a lot of fun together.
$1,000. That's pocket change, you bitch.
All I want to do is suck on your tits. Suck on those sloppy tits.
Louie.
Find a chick, you fucking fag.
Randy Callahan.
Okay, we...
Randy Callahan.
Louie, will you stop saying Louie?
I'm going to put his fucking head through a fucking brick wall.
All right. You want,
brick wall.
I hope you're Family Feud. You can't hurt me. You ready to play that feud? You ready to play with my balls? It's hot in here. I'm dying.
Okay. I don't think this is really promoting the show, Louis. We have to promote this show, right, Perry?
If it's a show. If I get this shit through the whole fucking...
You're not going to get...
Look.
Shut up. Now, Louis. Now, apologize to him. You really don't want to sleep with this guy, do you?
Not really, but I will. Fuck it. I already know he's gay.
How do you know he's gay?
Randy
how the
Callahan.
Fuck?
Randy Callahan.
All right.
Put those hairy balls in my mouth.
All right. That could be annoying to anybody, and I see that. Play, you know what? Play Mr. T. Maybe Louie won't like Mr. T.
I put it in food to fuck with Scary Perry, man. I'll break you in two, motherfucker. I take yours, and I'm going to rip your neck off, and I'm going to shove it down your throat.
Oh, you can shove anything down my throat.
I even make your own, suck your own dick, bitch.
I'll suck your big black dick. Because I know on the inside it's Perry's.
You really...
I'm dying.
Why are you dying, Louie?
Because I weigh too much.
I'm a little confused. Louie, why do you keep saying this about him?
Because I know a lot. I know he's a homo.
How do you know he's a homo?
Because of Randy Callahan. And I can tell by his forehead.
Let me say something to you, motherfucker.
Do it as one. Wait a minute. Do it as Mr. T. Do it a voice.
Listen here, fool. Number one, bitch. That was 20 fucking years ago. 20 fucking years ago. One motherfucking event. See my thumb? That means one, motherfucker.
One event.
20 fucking years ago.
9/11.
And I got in trouble, 9/11. Bitch.
9/11. 9/11 was one event, you cocksucker. Got it time here.
Okay,
I'm
it is.
Dying.
It is. Okay, Louis. I'm trying to promote a show on June 25th, and this is not working at all. Louis, you keep saying to Perry you want to suck his dick and that he's gay. He's not gay.
It's not that I really want him. It's just that I know he'd let me.
How do you know he'd let you?
Because he lets everybody. Because he's a fucking homo.
Do you think he's done other people besides Randy?
I can tell by his forehead.
What?
I can tell by a receding hairline. All that's cum. Oh, that's dry cum.
Do Jimmy Gutowski.
No.
No what?
No.
I don't know what you're saying no for.
He doesn't deserve it.
Help! Help! Come to the Comedy Store June 25th at 10 p.m. or I'll just die.
All right, damsel in distress. Just sit right here.
Hey, come on. Quit fucking around. Get that fucking cock in your face.
Get him out of here.
What, are you going to cry? Come on, don't be a dick. It's a nice thing to want to suck somebody's dick. It feels good. Well, don't you like things that feel good? You did 20 years ago. I mean, what the fuck? 9/11 was one event.
9/11 is one event? Is that what you said?
Why are you...
He says it's one event, like 20 years ago is one event. I said 9/11 is one event. Doesn't make everybody gay because of 9/11.
No, that's a...
But you are.
Get him the fuck out of here. Get him the fuck out of here.
Why?
Because I'm going to beat the shit out of him.
Perry, you're not going to... Why do you... Come on, try to be friends.
Look, I want nothing to do with him.
Why can't you be my friend?
You're a fucking queer.
And?
You're gayer than shit.
And?
You want to suck my dick.
And?
And you want to suck my dick.
And?
And you want to suck my dick.
And?
You want to eat my ass.
Yeah.
And you want to fucking suck my dick.
Well, sorta.
And eat my ass.
I do it.
And suck my dick.
Sure.
And keep eating my ass.
All right.
How do I shit down your fucking throat?
Sounds like it's settled. I'll meet you at Whole Foods. We'll do it in the parking lot.
I don't know if this is going to work. You know, that was today's mole play.
Mole play, mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play, mole play, let's play mole play. Mole play!
Maybe it is best that you just get the fuck out.
Yeah, I got to go anyway. Thanks. Bye, guys.
Well, thank you, Dr. Tommy Morris. I don't know what help he did.
Is it possible to plug my website?
Go ahead, yeah.
It's tastyjeff.com.
Tasty Jeff.
Oh, God. Fag site. Fag site!
You're first one there. Fucking homo. You're homo like me.
Get the fuck out of here.
Get the fuck out.
All right, well, that was nice. Dr. Tommy Morris.
Fucking guy, I mean, you know, that's what I was afraid of.
What?
For this fucking show.
Why?
That I'm going to have people that are going to tease me about the fucking Randy Callahan thing.
Okay.
And it's going to, look, that was 20 fucking years ago.
I understand.
I'm sick and tired of hearing about it.
I understand it, Perry.
It's over. What happened then happened then.
Well, anyway, I see by the clock on the wall, it's time to wrap things up. Now, I need to remind people for the last time, don't forget, on June 25th, the show of all shows, the first time the Big Three will be live together on stage since 1994. That's right, at the World Famous Comedy Store, 10 p.m. The ticket price, once again, $10 if you pre-order. You send that to tickets, care of Don Barris, 7510 Sunset Boulevard, number 153, Hollywood, California, 90046. They are $15 the day of the show. But don't forget, if you want to get the VIP donation tickets, you donate at least $100. You'll get a couple DVDs of some never-before-seen Big Three videos. Now, these aren't the little shitty things. You will be very surprised and very happy with what you get. You'll get an audio CD made especially for the VIPs. You'll get prime seating at the show. You'll get a T-shirt. You'll get a bunch of other stuff that comes in there. But if you go that extra mile and your donation is the highest donation, we couldn't get a sponsor to help us out with this show. So what we came up with an idea that maybe our fans could help us out with the VIP donation ticket. Now, what we ask you to do is we ask you to donate at least $100.
Which means more than $100?
Well, yeah, which means a lot more than $100. Somebody might,
$100,000.
Well, they might have two people. They want $1,000 apiece. We'd get $2,000.
How about somebody bidding their home?
Okay, that's not going to happen.
Shucks.
Now, if you do that, you can get...
Hey, Kim Kardashian, why don't you bid your house on this project?
That would be nice. Good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because you know what? That would mean that Kim Kardashian would come over to your house. Yeah. Shut up! Shut the fuck up! You're not funny. Oh, fuck. I'm trying to get something out.
I know. I'm
Shut
sorry.
The fuck up.
I'm sorry.
Shut the fuck up. Now, we ask you to at least donate $100 towards this, but you can obviously donate as much as you want. Now, if you do donate this and get the VIP sponsorship ticket, you're going to receive a kind of a nice prize package if you're a fan of the Big Three, because what you'll get two never-before-seen DVDs, and this will have classic Big Three moments. You know, you'll love that. We're going to make a very special audio CD, especially for the VIP ticket holder. You're going to be getting a 20th anniversary commemorative T-shirt that reminds the world to never forget. And you'll get prime seating for the show. Now, if you are the one that makes the biggest donation more than anybody else, here's where it gets crazy. Because then you and your guests, you're going to have a day with the Big Three unlike anything else. You're going to start out the day with a lunch over at Perry's apartment. You're going to get a chance to go into his apartment, take pictures, buy his trophy, and all the other shit in that little swamp of his. Then you're going to have a spaghetti dinner cooked by Perry and his manager, Nick. It's going to be by the poolside of his luxurious apartment. After lunch, you're going to go to the Comedy Store, where you're going to get a chance to see the rehearsal for the big show, and that's where you get a chance to pick your seat. Where do you want to sit? Well, wherever you choose, that will be your seat. Then you will go with me to my job. You get a chance to watch a show there. And after the show, you come back to the Comedy Store. And all along, I'm going to be your tour guide because we're going to give you transportation. We're going to take you around with that. In addition to all the other prizes you get with the VIP pass, and as the winner of the biggest donation, you're also going to get an autographed copy of the DVD Windy City Heat. Yeah, that's the one that we did. And an autographed Big Three Popsicle Stick skateboard. What an amazing package, and you get all that just for being the high donator. Anyway, if you want to get in touch with us on the social networks, don't forget, on Twitter, I'm at SimplyDon1. On Facebook, I'm at Don Barris. Perry, what's your Twitter?
Twitter's ScaryPerry818.
And also his Facebook is Perry F. Caravello, and that's K-A-R-V-A-V-E-L-L-O. So
I have three sites.
Yeah, okay, it doesn't fucking matter. Anyway, Walter Molininsky, who never made it here, he's at Walter Molininsky, and he's on Draw Something, Mole Something, I don't know.
That's it, Draw Something, Mole Something.
Draw Something, Mole Something. Anyway, that's... So, anyway, well, let's put her there. Guys, here we go. Big Three! And good night!